Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we have finished with our chapter 12, that is ratio and proportion. In today's class, we will be going to start with chapter 13, that is symmetry. Now, children, symmetry is not a new topic for you all. In previous classes also, we have done this symmetry. Let us understand what do we mean by symmetry first, and then line of symmetry and how we can divide a given figure into two same or two equal parts, that we will understand. Now chapter 13, that is symmetry. Now what do you mean by symmetry? If you went somewhere, like for example you went to Taj Mahal, went to see Taj Mahal in Agra, and in front of that Taj Mahal you will be finding one, that is pond in which water is filled. You will find the reflection of Taj Mahal in water, and you will say the reflection is same as of that actual Taj Mahal. Or if you will see like into a mirror, what you find it out, that is you are the same as of what you outside. So it means you are same, or symmetry is quite a common term which we use in our day-to-day life, which means identical. Means the two shapes or the two things, they are symmetrical to each other. How they can be symmetrical to each other? Here we can take example of some geometrical figure also. Here we can take an example with a paper also. We fold that paper, we will divide it into four equal parts. So these pictures, like architecture marvels, if you will look into it, you find it out, yes, that they can be divided into two identical halves, or the image or the reflection which we will be getting of those figures, that is again an identical figure. Now, making a symmetric figure or ink blot paper, that we can use it. Now, you have two set squares in your mathematical instrument. Are they symmetric or not? Let's find it out. So here, children, few of the question, if you understand, symmetric means identical. If you will divide a given figure into two equal parts, that line which divides that figure into two equal part is known as line of symmetry. And the two parts, they are identical to each other. Now list any four symmetrical object from your home or from your class. Now we can list this blackboard also. This blackboard can be divided into two equal parts. Soft board, table, chair, that can easily divided into notebook, book, that can be divided into two equal halves easily. Fine. Then let's start with this exercise, and then along with that exercise only we will be understanding the concept of the symmetry. Exercise 13.1. This question number 1, like list any four symmetrical object from your home or school. So you can name many more object. Now number 2, for the given figure, which one is the mirror line? Now you have been given with this figure, question number 2. Have been given with this figure, that is your question number 2. One line which is drawn from this side, that is L1, and one line which is drawn from here, that is L2. So here they were asking one question, that which line is dividing this whole figure into two identical parts. So if you will look it into this line, that L1, it is not dividing the figure into two equal halves. Like above one is triangle and below one is square. So what we can do it here, we will find it out that L2 is the line. So which line is mirror line? So L2 is the mirror line for given figure. mirror line for given figure. For given figure, A2 is the mirror line for given figure. Next, what we have here, identify the shapes given below and check whether they are symmetric or not. So what we need to do, it is the figure which you have been given, you need to draw a line of symmetry along each figure and then find it out whether it is symmetrical or not. If line of symmetry divides that figure into two equal halves, means both the sides you will be getting the same, then you will say yes, that is identical or symmetrical. Then third and fourth, same kind of a question will be there. Like in first A figure, you have been given a figure of clock. That is, then number 5, half of the figure have been given, question number 5. I am taking only those questions which are a bit different in terms of symmetry. That is question number 5. In the figure, L is the line of symmetry. Question number 5, already half of the figure is formed. L is the line of symmetry. L is the line of symmetry. L is the line of symmetry. Then what will be the other half of this figure? Complete the diagram to make it symmetric. So what we will be doing it on the other side again, another figure we will be drawing it. Now this is symmetrical to each other. Now this is symmetrical to each other. Right? This is now above one portion, this portion which is already given, you need to draw the other portion which is identical. Other portion which is identical. So this one is identical portion of the above one. Same kind of a question, that is question number 6. In the figure, L is the line of symmetry. Draw the image of the triangle and complete the diagram so that it becomes symmetric. So you need to change the figure to get or to know whether they are symmetrical or not. So figure with two line of symmetry, there are certain figure in which you will be getting two line of symmetry or more than one line of symmetry. So those kind of a figure, there are many those figure that you will be getting on that kind. So let us discuss those kind of figure in which you will be getting more than two line of symmetry. If I am going to talk about a square can be divided into, like, in many ways. This can be line of symmetry, this can be line of symmetry. This can be line of symmetry, this also can be line of symmetry. So there are 4 lines of symmetry in case of square. If I am going to talk about rectangle, then again rectangle also has 2 line of symmetry along with length side and this, that we can do it. So there are many more figure in which we will be having more than one line of symmetry. In case of triangle also, in case of kite also. Kite, what will happen in the case of kite? See, if I draw the figure of kite. So yes, that kite can be drawn into 2 identical parts. And there are many more figure in which we can divide it into more than 2 parts. Symmetry everywhere. So symmetry, like if we look into playing cards, there also we will be finding symmetry. So exercise 13.2, question number 1, that is related to find the number of symmetry for each of the following shapes. You have been given with many shapes in your book. Question number 1, you need to find it out the line of symmetry related to that. See, very easy if you need to find it out line of symmetry. With a given figure, you can find it out, or otherwise you draw that figure on a squared paper and you just find it out and then divide it into two equal halves. Or you can find it out that how many times we can divide it. That will help you to find it out the number of lines of symmetry. Number of lines of symmetry. So let's start with question number one of, in which you need to find it out lines of symmetry. Exercise 13.2. So question number one, find the number of lines of symmetry for each of the following shapes. So question number one, A part. Shape has been given to you. Now you need to find it out how many line of symmetry we can draw with this shape. So one is one, then two, then we can draw from here three, then four. Four lines of symmetry you can draw. So find the number of lines of symmetry for each of the following shapes. So here we have four lines of symmetry we do have. Four lines of symmetry we do have in this figure. Let's see another figure. How many lines of symmetry we can draw here? How many lines of symmetry that we can write it here? Then other figure is this figure, how many lines of symmetry it will be? 1, 2, or that will be again 3, then we will be having 4. So here again 4 lines of symmetry we can form with this figure. 4 lines of symmetry we can form of this figure. Then again one robot picture, D part, that is related to robot. Again in robot we will be forming one line of symmetry only. We will be having one line of symmetry only. Like if I talk about the face, you are drawing a face and you need to divide that face into two equal halves. So you can draw only one line of symmetry in this. I hope that is also clear again. Then you need to, if you have drawn a flower, there are certain cases in which you do not find any lines of symmetry. Like in case of flower, in clay case of flower, you do not get any lines of symmetry. You do not get any lines of symmetry. You do not get any lines of symmetry. Fine. Then many more figures we have in your book. Like copy the triangle in each of the following figure on a squared paper and in each case draw the line of symmetry. So line of symmetry, what is line of symmetry which is dividing that given figure into two equal halves? That is your line of symmetry. Then complete the table. Rough figure you need to draw and then line of symmetry you need to tell. That is, in case of equilateral triangle, Equilateral triangle, that we will see that how many lines of symmetry. A rough figure you need to draw. And then question number three, complete the following table in which you need to tell line of symmetry. Question number three, complete the following table. Equilateral triangle, now number of lines of symmetry, that is equilateral triangle, how many number of lines of symmetry will be there? All three sides were equal and it can be divided into three equal halves. Line of symmetry can be there. Then a rough figure of square. Just now we have done four line of symmetry. Then what next we have? We have rectangle. In case of a rectangle, we had two lines of symmetry. Then we have isosceles triangle, only one. In isosceles triangle, only two sides are equal. So we have only one line of symmetry. Then rhombus, again rhombus, there is in rhombus again we have four lines of symmetry. Then circle, there are infinite lines of symmetry. Then question number four, can you draw a triangle which has exactly one line of symmetry? Yes, that is just now we have done, that is isosceles triangle. Then exactly two lines of symmetry, yes, that is rectangle. Then exactly three lines of symmetry, yes, that is equilateral triangle. Then no line of symmetry, that is scalene triangle. Now in each case you need to draw a figure in your notebook. Then on a squared paper, sketch the following figures have been given, like a triangle with a horizontal line of symmetry. But no vertical line of symmetry. A quadrilateral with both horizontal and vertical line of symmetry. A quadrilateral with horizontal line of symmetry. Now in each case, figure has been suggested to you. Related to that only you need to form a figure with a line of symmetry. A hexagon with exactly two lines of symmetry that you need to form. So all these things will be there. Now trace each figure, such kind of it. Now letters also in English alphabet also, like O. O has infinite number of lines of symmetry. Then English alphabet A to Z, we can find it out, like vertical line of symmetry, like A. In A we have vertical, horizontal, like we have B. In B we have no line of symmetry, like Q. Q has a tail out which is coming outside from it, so it does not contain any line of symmetry. So reflection and symmetry, again one topic. Reflection means that is same figure which we can see on the other side. Mirror image according likewise we will be talking about the mirror image in reflection. And then so symmetry, few concepts were left that we will be discussing in our next class. Today we have done how to find line of symmetry, how this line of symmetry is important, and then we'll have an idea about practical geometry also, how this practical geometry is important and how we can go through with this practical geometry, that we will be doing in the next. Like first we will be trying to finish few more concepts which were left, that is related to this symmetry only, in our next class, and then we will start with the practical geometry again, in which a basic concept of geometry we will be taking into. So that's all for today, children. Have a good day.